So today we have the story of the call of the disciples. Before our call, and immediately they respond. Immediately they follow. They leave everything behind and follow Jesus. And we celebrate that. We honor that. That's okay. But I would have to ask, if we were in the place of the disciples, what would we do? I include myself in that. Probably we would not leave everything behind. There's wives at home, husbands at home, car payments, kids, a job, etc. And if you left everything in order to become a priest, I used to be in the vocation office. If somebody came in to me and said, "Hi, I want to be a priest. I just left my wife at home with all the kids and everything," I would say, "Please go back home." So could those disciples have said, "Yes, Jesus, I want to follow you," and still remain in the boat? I think it's a good question, because that's the situation that we're all in. We all have really important stuff going on. Good stuff, godly stuff. Spouse, kids, jobs, jobs for the common good. All good stuff. And we can't just drop those things. So what is this gospel trying to tell us today? All of us are baptized people. By our baptism, we've been called to be disciples, but we lead a whole different life. We make lives as bankers, teachers, engineers, whatever. We're moms and dads, grandmas and grandpas. We bring our faith to those ways of life. That's really our call. Vatican II says, our spirituality takes its character from one's state in life, whether married, single, priest, or religious. Seems pretty simple, but it's not easy to do. So what are we called to do then as we read this gospel today? First of all, if you are a mom or a dad, a grandma or a grandpa, raise ethical children. Teach them the difference between right and wrong, to care for others, loving and respecting other people, caring for their words and actions each and every day. Home is the first place for right teaching. And then if you're a business person, a worker, make your place where you work more just, more ethical, and care for others who are there. Don't cut corners. Don't try to screw over other people just to make more money. Don't charge exorbitant fees. We're called to make for a just society, not just more money for our organization or for me, but to really care for the common good. We're called to care for society, to be just in hiring people, all kinds of different ethical challenges in the workplace. The message that business sometimes sends out is exactly the opposite. Businesses thrive. Those are the ones that help themselves. They cut corners on ethics. And we would not want to emulate Ebenezer Scrooge, would we? A buddy of mine at the Better Business Bureau says, "John, you have no idea. There is no end to the scams that businesses are doing to their customers." And so we have to be better than that if we're going to follow this gospel today. So if you're at work, bring your ethics and your morals with you. John Paul II and now Pope Francis have criticized the economic systems of the world. And the immediate reaction is, "Well, just back off of that. Jesus has nothing to do with that." Well, maybe that's the problem. And so we have to take Jesus with us to work each and every day. I think also of the difficult task that politicians have. They vote on bills. And I remember one politician saying, "Well, when I go in to vote on a bill, I leave my religion at the door. That scares the bejesus out of me." You know why? Because that means you leave your moral and ethical framework at the door and don't even think about morals or ethics when you're voting. That is a little scary. That's a bad move for everybody. If you're a younger person and you're in school, think about anti-bullying. And are you using the internet in the correct way? Are you pro-school? Are you making your school a better place, a more respectable place, a more healthy place by your presence in it? So today, when we read in the gospel about the call of the disciples, we're called to leave the mundane path of our lives to become new and more Christ-like each and every day. It means to detachment from the old wineskins. That is, we've always done it that way. And it calls us to be more flexible and to our willingness to be stretched into uncomfortable places so that we can be people of creativity. So essentially, this gospel is calling all of us, no matter where we may find ourselves, to leave the old person behind and to become a new creation, a new disciple for Jesus.